What does CAPM stand for? The acronym CAPM stands for C, capital, A, asset, P, pricing, and M, model. What is the CAPM? The capital asset pricing model, or CAPM, identifies the relationship between systematic risk and the assured return of assets like stocks. In other words, it basically shows you how much risk you have to take to get a certain amount of return. CAPM is a great tool to price risk securities and find the expected returns of an asset based on the risk and cost of capital. The formula for calculating the CAPM is ERI equals RF plus beta I times ERM minus RF. ERI equals expected return of investment. RF equals risk-free rate. Beta I equals beta of the investment. And ERM minus RF equals market risk premium.
How does CAPM work? The beta coefficient of an investment measures a stock's volatility compared to the systematic risk of an entire market. The systematic risk is the non-removable risk of the stock market. The beta of an investment is the measure of how much risk the investment will bring to a portfolio that resembles the stock market. Theoretically, stocks with a beta coefficient less than 1 have smaller volatility than the market. Stocks greater than 1 will have a higher volatility than the market. Here are a few examples. A beta coefficient of 1 means that the stock moves perfectly with the stock market. However, if the beta coefficient of a stock is 1.5, it means that the stock price will rise by 15% if the stock market moves by 10%, and vice versa. A negative beta coefficient means that the stock and stock market moves in opposite directions. So for example, if the beta coefficient is negative 1, the stock will fall 10% if the stock market is up by 10%. A stock's beta will be multiplied by the market risk premium, which is the return expected from the market. The risk-free rate is then added to the product of the stock's beta and the market risk premium. Finally, the investor can get the required return or discount rate and use it to find the value of an asset. The ultimate goal for CAPM is to determine the true value of a stock. After determining the true value of a stock, investors can determine if the stock is overvalued or undervalued.
Example of the CAPM. Let's say there is an investor who is deciding to buy a stock worth $100 per share. The stock pays a 5% dividend. However, the stock's beta compared to the market is 1.4, which means it is riskier than a market portfolio. The risk-free rate is 2%, and the investor expects the market to rise 10% in value every year. The expected return of this stock based on the CAPM formula would then be 16.2. Because 16.2 equals 5% plus 1.4 times 10% minus 2%.
Problems with the CAPM. There are several aspects of CAPM that don't actually work in the regular world. By including beta into the formula, CAPM assumes that risk can be measured by a stock's price volatility. However, price movements in both directions are not equally risky, and stock returns and risk are not normally distributed. The CAPM also assumes that the risk-free rate will remain the same over a period of time. An increase in the risk-free rate also increases the cost of the capital used in the investment and can make a stock look overvalued. The most serious problem with CAPM is the assumption that future cash flow can be estimated for the discounting process. However, if an investor can really estimate the future return of a stock, then the entire CAPM is not even necessary.
CAPM and the efficient frontier. Using CAPM can help investors manage risk in their portfolio. If an investor is able to use the CAPM to perfectly optimize a portfolio's profit compared to risk, it would happen on a curve called the efficient frontier. The efficient frontier can be used to build a portfolio that has the most return with the least risk. The efficient frontier is generally the same as the CAPM and is only a theory. If a portfolio existed on the efficient frontier curve, it would make the most return for its level of risk. It is impossible to actually know if a portfolio is on the efficient frontier because we cannot predict future changes in the stock market.
Key takeaways. The CAPM uses the rules of the modern portfolio theory to determine if a security is fairly valued. It relies on investor behavior, risk and return, and market fundamentals that don't match reality. The underlying concepts of the CAPM and efficient frontier can aid investors to understand the relationship between expected risk and reward by looking at the total amount of risk and return achieved with adding a security to their portfolio. CAPM states that to generate higher return, you will need to take on more risk.
Thank you for watching Anime and Finance. Comment down below on whether you believe in the CAPM.